Make someone happy today. Give them a smile. Say hello. And come on, stand up and sing with us because it's time to come on in. Here we go. Into the love of the Creator. No matter who you are or where you are on life's journey, you are welcome here. I'd like to ask if there's anyone who is visiting us for the first time, and if you are, would you please stand? We're gonna have Dave come down, who's gonna give you a bag of popcorn to thank you for popping in today. We ask that you give us your name and where you're from, and that you give Dave a little bit of time because he's gonna get all of you guys.
Put your skin on, Dave. Come on.
I'm old.
Your name and where you're from.
Cody and Haley, Olivia and Nolan. We are from here. We're from Port Richey, about 5 minutes down the road.
Welcome. Glad to have you here. Welcome.
My name is Tammy. I live here in Port Richey, but originally from Indiana.
Welcome! Woo-hoo. I thought Gloria's here. She's from Indiana.
Hi, my name is Perry Contos. I'm from Columbus, Ohio. Go Buckeyes. But now currently here in Newport Richey.
Welcome. Glad to have you here.
I'm John Strauss, and I live at the Pines in Newport Richey on Congress.
Wonderful.
And I'm pleased to be here.
Glad to have you here with us today.
I'm Gordon Sozer. I'm from Illinois, and I'm visiting Community Church, No Denise.
Wonderful. Thank you. Glad to be here.
And I ran out of popcorn.
Uh-oh. Can we do IOUs anyways?
Two. I'm Jeremy, I'm from California.
Oh, wonderful, long way. Welcome. I do have a couple of announcements I'd like to share with you today. Inside the pews, you will find a white envelope. We're asking if anyone would consider in their hearts helping us out with our insurance bill. You've probably seen in your own home how insurance has gone wacko. It is unbelievable how much they want for us to pay for insurance on this church. And so if there is any way that you have it in your heart that you could give to that, we would really appreciate that. I want to remind people that I do provide a weekly newsletter that comes out on the internet on Mondays. If you do not get that and would like to get that, please take a little card that is in your pew or in the red book when you sign the red book and put your email address and I'll add it to it. That produced publication that I do every Monday has all of our Zoom activities, all the things that are going on in the church. We do ask that you sign the red book, and if you could get the red book to be towards the center aisle, it makes it much easier for us at the end when we are collecting those. I also want to let everybody know that we do have a grief group that meets the first and last Tuesday of every month on Zoom at 7 o'clock. We have a weekly Bible study that meets every Wednesday at 7 o'clock on Zoom, so you can be in your comfy chair at home with your fuzzy slippers on and still learn about the Bible. We have a choir rehearsal on Thursdays, and we're always looking for people to join our choir. And we have a wonderful and fabulous opportunity this year. We are building a community garden out here. And so you can see that lots of things are going on, and we're hoping to really help address the need in our community where there are so many people that are hungry. We're going to be doing educational opportunities for people to learn how to grow things in containers in their own homes. But right now what we are looking for are people to water. So how many of you like to play with a hose when you were a kid? This is an opportunity. You do, huh?
I'm supposed to be
saying. Oh, okay. Well, Robin's going to say this. I'm taking your thunder. Go ahead.
Okay. So I'm the garden gnome today. There's a gardening class within the next 2 weeks. More information will be available. If you can call Betsy, she'll give it to you.
We have Betsy stand so people can know who Betsy is.
Betsy, can you stand up on the pew so people can see you? He's from the Garden Extension Service at the University of Florida. He's going to do a little talk and then question and answers. So please come support us. The watering people, volunteers, there's a whiteboard in Andrews Hall next door. Please come over and sign up for a time to water, and then show up and do it. The next planting will be in August or September, late August, early September. It's too hot before then to do any more planting. Things won't survive. So we are going to grow what we have, gather what we can, and use them to feed those that need to be fed. The whiteboard, we did that. Oh, if you haven't been out to the garden in the last week, you should stop by. There are plants outside of the garden now, outside of the fence, that Kara, thank you, that Kara was so wonderfully put in there, and it looks beautiful. Go in the garden and check out what's growing. It doesn't take a long time to water out there, guys. Like, 10 minutes max. The hose is easy. You turn it on. And then you turn it off. It's really easy. Really easy. So, anybody can do it, even if you're 88. That's a hint, Dave. So, questions? Yes, sir.
There's no electronics involved in this?
None.
Oh, good. Thank you.
Yes, miss.
Okay.
What's your question, sweetheart?
I can't hear all of that. We'll talk about that later. How about that? Okay? All right. Yes, in the back. When is the extension person going to be here?
Betsy will give that to us as soon as she has it from him. But it's going to be within the next 2 weeks.
And then what I will do is I promise I'll send a special blast to everybody that's on our email so that you'll know the time and place where he's going to be. So,
certainly. Anybody else?
Okay. I want to let you know that this also complements that Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays from 11 to noon, we have our Love a Lunch program where we feed those who are homeless and those who are nutritionally challenged. This is the last week of school for many kids in Florida, and there are many families who get help with free lunches and free breakfast. So if you know someone who is in need, please let them know that Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, right here at the back, we do provide free food with water and beverages, and we have lots of volunteers who make wonderful, healthy food. So one of the things that we are trying to do is answer the call, feed my sheep. Our Pack a Sack program, where we feed the children during the school year, has come to an end because this is the school year is now come to an end, but we will be starting that back up in the fall. Are there any other announcements that need to be shared with our church at this time? If there aren't, I ask those who are able to please stand as we worship our living God. I ask you to take a moment and turn to the person on the right or the left to you and say, peace be with you. Let us join our voices together in the gathering call. Shout joyfully to the Lord, all the earth. Come into God's house with words of praise and hearts ready to worship. Sing to the glory of God's name. For God has refined us like silver. Led us through fire and flood and brought us out into freedom. Hallelujah. Amen.
Alrighty. You ready to sing? We're gonna take a little trip to the island.
Oh, your disciples. May we proclaim the greatness of your ways and welcome all into your love. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Sometimes we can't see God, just like our breath is there all the time. I have a balloon, and this balloon reminds me that, is it flat?
Yes.
Is it flat? Does it have any air in it? No. But if I stretch it, and I hope that it will work. Look what happened. It blew up. So the air is now inside it. I couldn't see that air a minute ago, but this tells me that there is air. And so this is how I know that there is God. I can't always see God, but I know that God is there. Just like a minute ago, that balloon was absolutely flat and we couldn't see the air, but now we can see it because God is here. You know a way that we know that God is around and how we can see God? It's when we do things that are nice and kind to one another, right? Because when someone is nice to you or says something nice to you, don't you feel the love of God being passed on? I bet you guys in there were fighting, right? You do have a bit. Good for honesty there, kid. But sometimes when you fight and you get angry, maybe you could stop and think about this. Think about God is around you. That you could be the words of God by saying two little words, I'm sorry, right? Or just, or even, and thank you, or by even saying, I love you, right? Because God's love is all around us. We don't always see it. A lot of times we forget it's there. A lot of times we think it's invisible and we can't see it. But like this balloon reminds us, God is always with us. We can't always see the air. We can't always feel the air. But it's all around us, just like the presence of God is. So let us pray. Oh Lord, we thank you for the gift of love. We ask that you'll help us to share your love with each other and help us to remember that even though we don't see you, you are still here. And when we love one another, when we forgive one another, when we're kind to one another, we help share that love with each other and let your presence be known. Okay, now, I have one yellow and red.
I like red.
You like red. You want red too? Okay. Well, thank you so much, and you have a great day. I'm glad you worshiped with us today. Oh, sweet. Our first scripture reading this morning is from the Hebrew Bible's Book of Psalms, Psalm 67. God, mark us with grace and blessing. Smile. The whole country will see how you work. All the godless nations see how you save. God, let people thank you and enjoy you. Let all the earth's people become happy and shout their happiness because you judge them fairly and you tend all the people of the earth. Let all the people praise you. Earth, display your exuberance. You mark us with blessings, O God, our God. Earth's four corners, honor the Creator. Let all people thank and praise you. You mark us with blessings, O God, our God. You mark us with blessings, O God. Earth's four corners honor the Creator. Well, that uplifting and wonderful psalm for this day. Let us join and all be giving praise today. Our second reading this morning is from the Gospel according to John, chapter 5, verses 1 through 9. After this, there was a festival of the Jews, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now in Jerusalem, by the Sheep Gate, there is a pool, called in Hebrew, Bethzatha, which has five porticos. In these lay many invalids, blind, lame, and paralyzed. One man was there who had been ill for 38 years. When Jesus saw him lying there and knew that he had been there a long time, he said to him, "Do you want to be made well?" The sick man answered, "Sir, I have no one to put me into the pool when the water is stirred up, and while I am making my way, someone else steps down in front of me." Jesus said to him, "Stand up, take your mat and walk." At once the man was made well, and he took up his mat and began to walk. Now the day was a Sabbath. Here ends our reading for this morning. It is a gift from God for the people of God. Know that it is true and can be trusted.
I'm very pleased to have some friends of mine from the Ritchie Orchestra performing with us. We have Lisa Cohen and her niece, Cindy Cohen. And I think Mom's out there somewhere. Yep, there she is. Okay. Enjoy this. Wearing lots of hats today. And for all you wondering, this is a bass clarinet.
Thank you.
we have gathered here today to sing your praises, to remember whose we are, to lift up our voices with all of our brothers and sisters throughout this beautiful planet, and to call you our Creator. Come, Holy Spirit, come and let your holy presence be known in my words and in our worship. Come, Lord Jesus, come. Teach us and expand our understanding of what it means to be a disciple in you. Come, creating God, come. Come and create within us the hearts that you desire. And may the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable to you, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer, now and forever. Amen. So, today we have a little different reading from the Gospel. We have a man who has been sitting beside a pool of blessings, a pool of healing. And I've learned this week a little bit about this pool. I don't think I've ever taken the time to read about it. But the story goes like this, that people would gather outside of the gates of Jerusalem, and they would wait. And every once in a while, the myth was that an angel would come down and stir up the pool. And if you were the first one into the pool, when the angel stirred it up, you were healed. What about all the other people? They're sort of left out. It tells us that this man that for 38 years, which was the lifespan of a normal adult during that time, for 38 years, he waited by the pool to be healed. And it never happened. 38 years, he was waiting for the miracle to change his life. 38 years, he was waiting for God to come and to work for him and work through him and do amazing things. Talk about persistence. Talk about faith. But then today, we have Jesus, who is going around and he is healing a lot of people. We know from our scripture passages that he's given sight to those who are blind. He's gone ahead and he's even brought Lazarus back out of the tomb when Lazarus was placed in the tomb and his sisters and everybody in the town thought that he was dead. Lazarus comes out when Jesus says, "Come on out." We even know that people were coming to him, sometimes crowding him so much for being healed. Help me, help my child, help my friend, help my neighbor. We even hear this story where some people take a paralytic man and they go on top of a roof that is thatched and they pull the thatch out and they lower their friend down so that Jesus will heal. This man doesn't come to Jesus. Jesus comes to him. This story. For 38 years, he's been sitting there. And Jesus comes along and asks him a very vital question. He doesn't say, "My son, you're magically healed." He doesn't go and touch him. He says, "Do you want to be healed? Do you want to be healed?" I was in a bookstore the other day. And I was looking at the health self section. It's gotta be a multi-billion dollar industry out there. You can find anything, how to get motivated, how to cure everything in 21 days, how to get magically abundant, how to stop your negative behavior, how to get rid of your people around you that have negative behavior. You name it. There's all these things, all these self-help things out there. For us, because a lot of us want to change. A lot of us look at ourselves and we see there's things that we want to change. But you know what? Getting that book, it's nice to get that book. I have a friend who has a whole stack of them. And I said to her, "Do you read them?" "Well, I really haven't gotten around to it yet." Bought them, but haven't gone ahead and done the work. You see, a lot of us find things in our lives that we want to change. That takes commitment. That takes time. That takes the willingness to change. Do you want to be changed? Do you want to be healed? Do you want something different than what you have? Jesus asks. And the man says, yes. He believes. He has faith. He's stayed there for 38 years, and he's believed that a change will happen, that a divine change will happen. He believed it was a kind of come to him from an angel, but it came instead from the living God. Do you want to be changed? They believed, he believed that God could come and change him. You know, I think there's a lot of us out there that want something different in our lives. We've been praying and praying and praying, and maybe it hasn't come. Sometimes we get discouraged. But it's important to realize that if we continue to pray, if we continue to try, if we continue to want to change and to put the work into it, we can get there. I remember a long time ago, I'm going to date myself here, I was watching an Oprah Winfrey show way back when, and they had this secretary who was on there. And she said that she had been reading, and her job was to go through and to read and to scan possible children's books. And she came across this one that had already been rejected by 3 or 4 other companies, and she said, oh my gosh, this is a winner. And she went to her editors, and her editors said, nah, I don't think so. She said, no, listen, you've got to look at this book. You have to look at this book. And they looked at it, and the author admitted that they'd gone from one place to another, to another, to another, and every time they got the rejection note. But she kept trying and kept trying, and this one person read her story and believed in her, believed that this children's book would be set on fire. Have you ever heard of Harry Potter? Think about all those people who said no, no, no. I learned this week from another pastor that Michael Jordan was actually cut from his high school team. You see, sometimes things don't just come easily. This man sat there for 38 years, but when asked the right question, do you want to be healed? He answered yes. He was ready for change. He was not going to give up. He was persistent in his faith. He kept showing up time and time again, ready and willing for the miracles of God to work in his life. Are you ready for change? Is there something that God wants within you to change? Is there something that God is pulling you to do? That maybe you've lost your faith that it's actually going to happen. Maybe you're like the Coca-Cola company that I learned that the first year that they were in business, they sold a whopping 400 bottles of soda. But they didn't give up. And look at them now. You see, this story today, I think, is for us to look at and to remember that things always don't always come easily. A lot of us, I think, believe that once we say we are Christians, we believe in the risen Lord, we believe in the one who died on the cross for us, we believe in our Redeemer, the tomb is empty, that all of a sudden we're going to have sparkles and unicorns all around us. But to be a disciple means that you have to have faith and you have to be willing to work at it. Look at those people that Jesus called in the stories of the gospel. Their lives were not easy. Their faith was strong. And they knew that they were doing the work of God, but they had to overcome challenge after challenge after challenge. Do you want to be made well? And day after day, they put on their sandals and they said yes, and they went out and they did the work of the kingdom. They did the work of God because they believed and they knew that things can get better, that things will be made better if we answer yes. We want to be made well. Yes, we want there to be a change. Yes, we don't want to sit here like we have for so long. We want there to be something different. We believe in the promise of the risen Lord. We believe in the promise of the empty tomb. We believe that our life can and will be better if we answer that simple question. Do you want to be made well? Do you want to live in the life of Christ? Do you want to know what it means to be truly disciples of the living Lord? This week I was in a meeting, and many of our leaders were discouraged. They were saying, there's only a handful of us. We work and we work, and we need more people to help us. Is it ever going to change? We keep praying that God will send us people to help us, but it hasn't happened. I would said and think, we need to ask our congregation, do we want to be the people that God created us to be? You see, when I look at this church, I see so many gifts and so many possibilities. Look at the location that God has given us. Look at this location. Right there is the city. Right there walking by us, day in and day out, are people who do not know the message of God. Day in and day out, there are people that have been hurt by the church because they've been told that they're not worthy enough to walk into these doors, because they've been told that who they love or how big they are or how much money they have or what their background is not good enough. There's people walking by right now. And we have a message to say to those people. All are welcome here. God has given us that message. God has given us that amazing parking lot back there. There's a lot of churches that have location, but they don't have that parking lot. They don't have a place for the people to park. And we do. God has given us a message that the world needs to hear today in this broken time. And yet we only have a few people who are trying their absolute darndest and exhausting themselves trying to carry that message forward. I want to ask everybody who's sitting in the pew today, do you think we've been sitting by the well long enough, praying that God would bring more people into this church, into this message, into this ministry? Do you think it's time for us to stand up and say, we want to be the people that God created us to be? We want to be well. We want to stand up with this message. We want to take our mat and go out and share the good news. And I'm willing to be part of that. We all have gifts, every single one of us. I've heard people say, someone in this room's going to chuckle, oh, but we're retired. We're so tired. But when I ask those same people who are retired, can you pick up the phone? Yes. Can you send a note? Yes. Can you serve on a team? Probably. But I like sitting here in my pew. Bob Rabita calls those who sit in their pews pew potatoes. Like couch potatoes. But I think we have maybe too many pew potatoes, and we need to have more people that are willing to take up the mat and say, here I am, and I want to work for the kingdom of God, for the kingdom of God is broken, and I wanted to see it made well again. I want to see those people that are out there that are hurt and broken come in here so that we will thrive. There's a song that our choir used to sing all the time. We were made to thrive. I don't think God looks down at a church and says, oh, this church is meant to be mediocre. This church is meant to dwindle. Uh-uh. That's not the message of our God. Our God is a God of great insight. Our God is a God of great hope. Our God is a God of great transformation. What does Jesus say before he ascends up? Go and make disciples of all nations. People of God, we've been sitting by this pool too long. Do you want to be made well? Do you want to proclaim the gospel? Do you want to welcome new people into this church? Do you want to be the church that God created you to be? What's your answer? Yes, sir? There you go. Amen. Thank you.
6:8.
The question is for you to answer. Are you going to be like Michael Jordan and have a coach tell them they're not good enough and then give up? Or are you going to be like Michael Jordan and say you're not good enough and say, oh, darn it, yes, I am, and keep on going and be the success and be the people that God created you to be? That's a question everyone needs to ask here. I believe that God wants us to thrive. I believe that we have been waiting here. Our time is done. It's been 38 years, 48 years, 15 years, whatever it has been. And God is asking us the question today. Are you, people of God, ready to rise up? Are you ready to volunteer? Are you ready to put your faith into action? Are you ready to take your mat? Take the word of the gospel. Go out there and let everybody know that there is a place for them, where God lives, where hope lives, where transformation lives. I hope you'll answer when God asks, are you ready? Do you want to be made well? Do you want to help heal the church? Do you want to proclaim the message? I hope you will say, yes, sir, I am. Amen.
Amen.
We have been blessed beyond our wildest imaginings. And if you don't believe that, I ask you to take a breath in and a breath out and remember whose you are. It is the Creator who gave you that breath. It is the Creator who gave you this life. It is the Creator who gave you all the people in your life that make your life so wonderful and blessed. Let us now give back to God a portion of what we have received by supporting the ministry of Jesus Christ right here in this church. Let us now receive our morning offering. Please stand. So that we may go out and let all know that there is healing and transformation in you. We pray this in your name, God of many names. Amen. Amen. Please be seated. As we come to our prayer time, I want to say that we have a lot of people who are in need. We have Ralph, who is in rehab, Marie, who has been moved into rehab. We have Marie Roxbury, who is healing from cancer. We have people who are grieving. Jim Lane's son passed away from Parkinson's. We have Joyce's wife, who is battling cancer. We have, I noticed that we saw that there was a tornado that hit the upper part of the lower peninsula of Michigan in Gaylord. And we used to have a member of ours who used to play his clarinet, and that is where he lives. So I'm hoping that he is okay and the people there are okay. I ask that you pray for all of our people who are struggling. I ask that you pray for all those who are in need. For Marilee's daughter-in-law, who had to say goodbye to her mother, as her mother has been diagnosed with a terminal illness. I ask that you pray for the people of Ukraine, for the people who are victims of human trafficking and addiction, and those who are caregivers, and those who are victims of violence, and places where there is gangs and hatred and division. May the love of Christ come through. I ask now for you to lift up. Raise your hand if you have a prayer request or celebration. Yes.
My sister, Julie.
Julie. Oh, loving God, we lift up to you, Julie, into your tender care. We ask that you'll surround her with strength and the needs and fulfill the needs that she has. I ask that we pray for Kim, who continues to struggle with health issues day in and day out. Oh, Lord, we lift Kim up to you. We ask for your healing for her. Yes.
My sister, Marianne.
Marianne. Precious God, we lift up to Marianne, who is in need of your holy presence, in need of your transformation. We pray this to you.
Chris.
Oh Lord, we lift up to Chris. We ask that you will surround Chris with your love, with your strength, with your presence. May Chris always know that you are with them, constantly and forever. Amen. Yes?
A portion of my family in Texas, my niece Lori, her husband, her son, two of their little babies, 6 weeks with COVID.
We ask, oh Lord, that you'll be with Kim's family, for she has 6 people right now who have COVID. Bring them back to health, O Lord. Help them and guide them during this struggle. We pray this in the name of the one who died on the cross for us. Amen.
My friends John and Molly, who are traveling back from New York after burying their oldest son.
O Lord, we pray for John and Molly as they grieve the loss of their only son. We ask that you, their travels will be safe, but we ask, oh Lord, that you'll be with them during this time of grief, that you'll lift them up, that you'll give them the strength that they need, and help their hearts to be comforted. Yes.
Pray for Greg recovering from pneumonia.
Oh Lord, we pray for Greg who is recovering from pneumonia. We ask that you'll help his body to heal and be knit back together into strength. We pray this in the name of the one who can do all things. Let us pray. Oh, loving God, we come here today. We come here today, some of us with heavy hearts, some of us questioning, some of us filled with joy. We come here as your people into this sanctuary to remember whose we are. We are the children of the living God, that we are meant to walk side by side with each other, to support each other, to share the love of Christ with each other. Sometimes, O Lord, your presence seems as invisible as air, and yet we know that you are there. We know that you call us to change our ways, to choose the healthy ways, to be your disciples, to answer, yes, Lord, we want to be changed. Yes, Lord, we want to be healed. Yes, Lord, we want to be your disciples. O Lord, send us the power of the Holy Spirit so that we may change our ways, so that we may answer your call to be your disciples and to be the church that you have intended us to be, so that we can share the message with those who are hurting, with those who do not feel that they have enough room in the kingdom of God. Let our message go out and welcome all people in. Bring healing to this world and into all the dark places, into the hospital rooms, and into the places where there is division and hatred and violence and guns and angry words and discrimination. Break down those walls, O Lord. Heal your people. Heal our human heart, we pray. We pray for all the struggling churches and for the big churches. We pray for all the people who have not heard of the word of Christ. We pray for all those who are questioning. And in the silence, we come before you with our own private prayers, knowing that even when we pray silently, you are there for us. Hear us now in the silence. Transforming, inspiring, creator of all the universe, we stand on our faith today and we say, yes, we want to be transformed. Yes, we want to be the healing instruments that you created us to be. Yes, we want to bring hope to the hopeless. Yes, we want to bring the message of Jesus to those who do not hear. And as a sign of our dedication and yearning and willingness to follow you, we join our voices together today in saying the prayer that Jesus taught us to say when we pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, power, and the glory forever. Amen. I invite those who are able to please stand.
Rise up! We're going to sing this.
Thank you.
you. May you know that you are loved beyond your wildest imaginings. Go forth, people of God, and spread the good news that all are welcome into the kingdom of God. Go now in peace.